in the name of Jesus Christ. I welcome you to this service in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He's risen. He's no more dead. He's risen. He's risen. So I know everything that is dead in your organ is taken back to life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Everything called sickness, every cancer is canceled today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Every cancer is canceled today in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Every depression, everyone you have been oppressed by the devil, you are set free today in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Every kind of rheumatism pain that is in the house right now, every kind of pain that you are having right now is gone now in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. Quickly, John 14:19. John 14:19. Studio. John 14:19. Yes, a little while, and the world seeth me no more, but ye see me, because I live, ye shall live also.
Amen.
Because I live, ye shall live also.
Amen.
If Jesus live, your organ live.
Amen.
If Jesus live, your destiny is alive.
Amen.
If Jesus live, your womb is alive.
Amen.
If Jesus live, your marital breakthrough is alive.
Amen.
If Jesus lives, your financial breakthrough is alive.
Amen.
Please understand today's service. Understand today's service. Understanding is what makes one to outstand in life. Please understand. If Jesus lives, your business is alive. Because he lives, you are carrying the living person, so you are alive. He that is in me is greater than he that is in the world. He that is in you is alive.
Amen.
So you can't be dead. Your business cannot be dead. You can't be a sickler. You can't be having one pain or the other, because you are carrying the one that is painless. Galatians 2:20. Galatians 2:20. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. So if Christ lives in you, how will you have sickness? If he lives in you, you cannot be a poor man. If he lives in you, you are carrying the one that is alive. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Please understand this morning, a day like this comes once in a while. Till next year again, before you can see a day like this. So maximize today. This is not just a regular service, sir, ma'am. Maximize today. A day like this come once in a while. A day like this come once in a while. Understand the efficacy of his resurrection power this morning to get all your desire met. All seasons are not the same. All seasons are not the same. This resurrection season is a season of change of position. It's a season of change of position. In other words, where they used to see you, they will see you no more over
there.
Where they used to see you, that ground you used to be, you are no more there.
Amen.
Because you are redeemed for the top. That is to say, the ground has overflowed. The top is where space is. The ground is overflowed. The top is where space is. There's not how much of you and I that is up can be full, but the head can be filled up. But the sky cannot be filled. I pray this morning, standing on the shoulder of my Father, my God is changing your position. in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
My God is changing your position in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
While I was studying, God said, just tell them, every delay of the womb in the sanctuary is ended.
Amen. Amen.
Said, tell them, every delay of the womb. Watch it. According to the time of life, by this time 9 months, we are celebrating them.
Amen.
In their numbers.
Amen.
In their numbers.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So every delay of the fruit of the womb is changing to miracle children today in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I declare you pregnant now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As many that are in the house, I declare you pregnant now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He said, tell them again, every eligible single, this is the year of your colorful marriage.
Amen.
Every eligible single in the house, this is the year. Please maximize this time. This kind of word just comes once in a while. It doesn't come regularly. I don't know what you are going through, but you are changing position.
Amen.
In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are changing position.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. But quickly, what is in the power of his resurrection? What is in the power of his resurrection? Because we're going to dance today. We're going to shamify the devil and glorify God.
Amen. Yeah.
Resurrection is the greatest event in the Christendom. Resurrection is the greatest event in the Christendom, because if Christ did not rise from the dead, our faith is in vain. And we are yet in our sin. 1 Corinthians 15, 17 to 20. 1 Corinthians 15. And if Christ be not raised, your faith is in vain. Ye are yet in your sin. Then they also which are fallen asleep in Christ are perished. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. But now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruit of them that slept. I said, listen, his birth is very important. But his death and his resurrection is more important. His birth is very important. But the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ is more important. If he does die and never, you and I, we are Christendom is useless. It is his death and his resurrection that bring value to you and I, Christians. His birth, fine. He was given birth to. We all celebrate his birth. But his death and his resurrection is far more important. So understand today. Don't toil with it. Don't do any out thing with it. Just connect today. Connection is collection. Until you connect, you are not collecting.
Mm-hmm.
Connect today. Connect today. Today is not the day you go and be drinking beer or drinking. Today is the day that you connect yourself. For you to understand the efficacy. Until you plug your phone, the plug into electricity, it's not collecting any power. So connect this morning for you to collect what God has for you. You will not miss it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not miss it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because it's the resurrection power of life. God himself is the resurrection power of life. You and I, our hope would have been lost. Our hope will be lost. The first miracle of Christ after he rose from death was an eye-opening miracle. That is, the veil over the heart of man was taken away. Luke 24. Let's read Luke 24, 13. Luke 24, 13. We read 13, 18, 30, and 31. I'm not going to read all through. I will just explain. And behold, two of them went that same day to a village. You can read all through from 30 to 31 when you get home. And behold, two of them went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem, about threescore furlongs. 18. And the one of them whose name was Cleopas, answering, said unto him, art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem? He never knew he was going with Jesus. Jesus was asking him, what's going on? What's happening? But are you a stranger in Jerusalem? He never knew. And has not known the things which are come to pass there in these days. And it came to pass, verse 30, as he sat at the table with them, he took bread and blessed it, and prayed and gave them, and their eyes were opened, and they knew him, and he vanished out of their sight. That is what happened to so many of us. We have the solution, but we don't know we have the solution. Your Bible is with you, but you don't know this is your problem solver. There we are with Jesus Christ, they never know. You have your Bible, but you don't know this is your solution. You keep worrying yourself, you keep looking for solution where you have solution. You have everything in life in this world. This is the world of life. The oldest and the latest. They were with Jesus, but they never know they are with Jesus until he broke the bread. This morning, your eye will be opened in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. For what God has for you, leave what people are saying. It is what God says about you that matters. What people are saying is not a concern. What God, what are you saying to yourself? What are you saying to yourself? When you read through your understanding that there were with problem solver, when you read the Bible, you don't know. You just carry it. Because we just read, we never get the revelation of it. Don't just study. Ask God, show me. Open the eyes of my understanding in your word. The day I caught my own word in the book of, let me open that one. Let me just remind myself of that Bible verse. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Exodus 3:17. Studio. Exodus 3:17. This was the word that is keeping me going, and I'm still going with it. And I have said, I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt unto the land of Canaan, the Hittite and the Amorite and the Perizzite and the Hivite and the Jebusite, unto a land flowing with milk and honey. He will bring me out. I was in one kind of situation, but I was just studying the word. That word hits me like a thunderbolt. That he will bring me out. Everywhere you are that is not good is Egypt. Everything that you are doing that is not making progress is Egypt. Every work that you are in now, that you work is making progress, you are not making progress. Please take you, run yourself, take yourself out. That is Egypt. Why the complaint is rising, you are not rising. Please change job. God will give you another one this week.
Amen.
Everything you are doing that there is no progress in it is Egypt. And I thought that word, he will take me out, sir. I wrote jam like 6 to 7 times. With that one. The first one that came out, I got it, but there was no physics. And I got it. The year I got this Bible verse was the year I got admission. That it will take me out of that affliction of jam writing by Egypt. I don't know what kind of sickness you have this morning, but my God is taking you out of that sickness in the name of Jesus Christ. Every kind of business stagnation, every kind of thing you are going through, in this very morning, this morning of resurrection, my God is resurrecting you out in the name of Jesus Christ. He will take you out. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. His resurrection is not in vain, but for your gain. His resurrection is not in vain, but for your gain.
Maximize it. Make use of it. Not in vain. If the Lord does not die and resurrect for nothing, he died and resurrect for my gain and your gain. His resurrection is a revolutionary power. It's a revolutionary power. It's a revolutionary power because there must be a change. 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 Walk in the power of his resurrection. Number three. Through our new access to light, we are empowered to dominate the kingdom of this world. Through our new access to light, we are empowered to dominate the kingdom of this world. Because revelation is our access to the power of his resurrection. Revelation is our access to the power of his resurrection. Please, have revelation. Say that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Ephesians 3. That I may know him. That I may know him. Philippians 3, sorry. That I may know him. That I may know him. Ephesians 1, 18 to 20. The eyes of your understanding be enlightened. Ephesians 1, 18 to 20. The eyes of your understanding be enlightened, that ye may know what is in the hope of his calling, and what is in the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is in the exceeding greatness of his power towards who believe. So it is your believing. Your believing is what makes your revelation to be real. If you don't believe, you can't see anything. Luke 1:45. Blessed is she that believeth. Blessed is she. Your believing is your revealer. It is what you believe that God will reveal to you. Believe you are coming out today. Just believe you are coming out today. That everything that is dead in your life, believe that everything God's sickness is, you are out of it today. Amen. Because he himself too, he has carried everything to cross. He has said it is what? Finished. So where did you find the sickness? I am angry with sickness this morning. And God, Easter healing is coming to the house in the name of Jesus Christ. Get the understanding of his power according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. In other words, you are in the heavenly places. Amen. Far above sickness and diseases. Amen. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Number four, the power of his resurrection delivers instantly. So, check, just watch it. Just put your belief and put your heart instantly. The power of his resurrection delivers instantly, instantly, instantly. 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 52. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. We shall all be changed. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Is that in a moment? So instantly, in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump of the trumpet shall sound. In a moment, 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 in a moment. In this moment, in this very moment, I decree healing to everyone called sick in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Everything called cancer is canceled this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Every HIV, God is nullifying them tonight, today in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Whatever that is not functioning in your life, begin to function right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. The power of his resurrection is ordained for our supernatural change. Supernatural change. When he rose up, everything changed. Everything changed when he rose up. Luke 24, 5 to 6. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the head, they said unto them, why seek ye the living among the dead? He is risen. It's not yet. Remember how he spake unto you when he was in Galilee. That is a supernatural change, sir. Nobody believes it. If they believe, they wouldn't have buried Jesus. They wouldn't have killed him. Because it has never happened before. It has never happened before. It has never happened before. Everyone that has been mocking you before shall celebrate you from now in the name of Jesus Christ. They mock Jesus. I watched the video. I was crying as if I have not seen it before. They pushed up. They mock it when you call yourself the ruler, the king. Why not save yourself, man? Carry all kinds of clothes, all kinds of things. Mock him. People might have mocked you in your place of work, but today they are celebrating you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. People might have mocked you that you have married for years and nothing to show, but today they are celebrating you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. People might have mocked you that look at it, keep going to church, you keep going to church, but nothing to show. But those people have been the ones to celebrate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. What again? From filthiness to holiness. From filthiness to holiness. What is in the power of his resurrection? From filthiness to holiness. From filthiness to holiness. Paul was saying that, for the good that I would do, I do not. But the evil which I would not, that I do. Now, if I do that, I would not. It is no more me, I, that do it, but sin. Many of us want to do good, but the sin seek taking us to go and do the bad thing. Many of us want to change from that filthiness, but that sin, on you now be that, oh, I've done this thing again, I don't want to do it, I've done it again, I've done it again, I've done it again, I've done it again. But this morning, you are setting loose in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You are setting loose in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Everything that you have done that has brought regrets into your life, today, God is setting you free in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You don't want to do certain things, but you just came. You just do it. You just do it. But today, an end has come to that in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Matthew 1:21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. So God is there today to save you from your sin. To save you at night from our sin. Certain things you don't want to do, but you see yourself doing it. You don't want to lie to your wife, but you still lie. You don't want to do some fornicate, you still fornicate. You don't want to drink, but you still drink. You don't want to smoke, but you still smoke. You don't want to do adultery, but you still do it. It's a force. But today, God is setting you free in the precious name of Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:42. So also is the resurrection of death. It is sown in corruption. It is raised in incorruption. It is sown, he died in corruption. But he rose up with incorruption. And you are rising up today. Inside incorruption, in thy name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In your place of work, stand for incorruption. In your marriage, stand. If you tell lies, it's corruption. It's corruption. In among your children, stand for incorruption. You are free today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are having dominion over them today in the precious name of Jesus.
Amen.
According to Romans 6:14, he said, for sin shall not have dominion over you anymore. For sin shall not have dominion over you anymore in thy name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What again? From weakness to strength. Say, let the weak say what? From weakness to strength. The power of his resurrection bring you from weakness to strength. From weakness to strength. From weakness to strength. No more weakness for you anymore in the precious name of Jesus Christ. No more weakness for you anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:3 said, it is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, but it is raised in power. In power. No more weakness for you anymore in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Revelation 5:12 said, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive what? Power. To receive power. Power. Power, power. From today, you are empowered in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What they came from shame to glory. From shame to glory. So shame is coming to an end today.
Amen.
Shame is coming to an end today.
Amen.
Marital shame. Financial shame. Everything is coming to an end today in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Revelation 5:12 said, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Who has given us what? Glory. You find glory in again. Glory in it. From shame to glory. Worthy is the Lamb who has given you and I glory, power, riches, and wisdom, and strength, and honor, and glory. There is glory inside of you. You are not meant to be shamed. You are not meant to be at no more shame in your life.
Amen.
In the life of your children, no more shame.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. What they came from captivity to liberty. From captivity to liberty. From captivity to liberty. Matthew 27, 50 to 53. Matthew 27, 50 to 53. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain, from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and rock rent, and grave were opened. Your grave is opened up today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And many bodies of the saints were slept arose, and came out of the grave after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. As your appearance to your place of work this week, as your appearance to your place of work this week, in your house, as your appearance to that place this week, you are into liberty in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
No more captivity for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are set loose.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
John 8:32 said, and yet know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. This is the truth. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the truth. What they came from sickness to health. From sickness to health. From sickness to health. Romans 8:11. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from death dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from death shall also quicken your mortal body. He raised Jesus from death. So he's meant to quicken your mortal body. You are not meant to be sick. I'm not too angry about sickness today in the house. You are not meant to be sick. Sickness is not your portion. By privilege, since 2019, forever, no medication. It is my connection I collected from the man of God. I have him say, yay, I can never be sick. I'm like, you can never be sick. And I gave myself, and since that time, till forever, sir, no, by privilege. 2000. If I don't take Biritin, for those that are in Nigeria, if I don't take Biritin, I can't sleep. Before I got connected to God, if I don't take Biritin, I can't sleep. But today, I can sleep standing there. From 2009 till forever, no medication. Sickness is not part of you. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from death, you are not dead. If he can raise up Jesus from death, what is that sickness that he cannot take away? He himself took my sickness and he has took it. Where did you find it? I had one of my pastors said, it's either you inherited it or you stole it. Because what has been taken cannot be found. If he took, where did you find it? You stole it. Return it back to them. It's not your portion. He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body. Your body is mortal. Jesus only is immortal. If immortal, enter into mortal. You are a rock, a lively stone. Stone don't seek, sir. Stone don't seek, man. You are a stone, a lively one. The one that, a stone that lives. And the enemy that eats you, their head will scatter.
Yes.
Romans 8:17 said, and if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. So if we are joint heirs, why, where are you getting it from? meant to be positive and negative. We are positive. We attract. We are not meant to be repelled. There is no repellence. This attraction. So where did you get it from? When God is not sick and you are joint heir with Him. So where did you get the whole sickness from? That is going to be sparking blood. You know, negative. They will just. We are meant to attract, not to repel, not to go this way and one this way. From poverty to prosperity. From poverty to prosperity. He said, I became poor for you to be rich. A child of God is a gold, sir. Our God is a rich man. I must be a rich man. You cannot see a son of a king and you don't know, no, this is a prince. Let alone the King of Kings. From poverty to prosperity. Sir, poverty is bad. He turned the eldest to the youngest. Poverty is bad. If you don't have money, say you have idea, to hell with your idea. Your idea will not speak anywhere. Understand that he himself has given you riches. I became poor for you to be rich. What would that sacrifice mean? He said, I wish above all the touch unto that yet may be riches. He wants you to be rich. He wants your health. He wish above all things. Second Corinthians 8:9. For ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, that yet through his poverty might be rich. Poverty is a disease. We have been in America still, there's nothing to show. But from today, because of the declaration, there is a change. Sudden one. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Sudden one. In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From poverty to riches. Revelation 5:12. Sing worthy with the loud voice. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and what?
Riches.
Riches. Don't think poor, sir. Whatever you like, say it. You cannot be thinking poor and get money and be rich. Don't think poor. Think big. Your God is a big God. When you see a 2019 car, love it. Oh, I love this car. I'm going to get you soon. You think it. If you don't have the money, one of my pastors said, go and window shop and just say, wow, soon I'm coming for you. It happened to that neighbor. He said he saw a Rolls Royce and they like, he liked it. And I'm like, wow, don't worry, soon I will get it. And he got it, sir. The answer is in your inside. The answer is inside of you. You have it. You have the answer inside of you. But it takes your revelation to bring it out. What of if I say it, I don't get it? Leave if out of it. Say it.
Yes. Yes.
You are not the one that owns the world. The world himself has had you. Jesus is the world. Poverty is not a good thing. That one they know that he made you that is the head of brother to be a young brother. It is great. It's not a good thing. That if you don't call them, when your elder brother say, okay, plus he must take it easy. You must take it easy. He has no choice than to take it easy. Because there is no substance to show. No money. It's not a good thing. Please, hate poverty. Say, I hate poverty.
I hate
poverty. Say again, I hate poverty.
I hate poverty.
Say again, I hate poverty.
I hate poverty.
Say, he has taken away Emmanuel's poverty.
I'm
saying, love it, darling. Call my name. He has taken Emmanuel's poverty. You guys are sorry. So this is the love, right? The love ended on the other. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Say Emmanuel is from poverty to riches.
It is what?
Amen.
Now I know where he placed me. I know, so I can't just buckle my shoe anymore. And so please get the understanding that he became poor for you and I to be rich.
Amen.
It is revelation of prosperity that terminates poverty. It is the revelation of prosperity that terminates poverty. You cannot be thinking poor and be rich. And then look rich always for you to be rich. Look rich always. I don't have too much of it though. But if I dress specifically, your money is too much.
I don't
have plenty of it. But when you see me in the mirror, I don't have my chapstick out. I don't want to think poor, sir. I'm not a poor man.
No.
And what a privilege. You are in the rich church, the richest church in the whole world.
Amen.
If our spiritual father is rich, we that are followers must be richer. Poor is different from prosper is different from poor. Or prosperity, we want to go. We are not going to go. Poor is different. Catch the prosper. Leave the poor. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Your maker is a rich man, though. Don't look poor.
Amen.
Don't look poor.
Amen.
Don't dress poor. Even when I have just, when I first came to the country, I only have just one, no, two suits. If you see the way I wash and dry clean it, because I just came now. So the one I have in Nigeria is what I have. If you see the way I do things, sir, you won't know it's just two. Oh, until people start blessing me. Oh, the pastor take this suit, pastor take this. It was two. And even my shoes, it was just one I brought. My wife bought two other two, but I know the other two she bought, American one, Nigerian one, what I love more. Then I'm not used to the system. So I love, if you see the way I bring blood polish from Nigeria, I look rich. You won't see me poor, no.
Hallelujah.
I rap from my small, I don't look poor. I don't, in my university days, I don't look it. When things was not working, you still see me, I'm working it out. When it's not working, I'm working it out. People were like, my mom is just a lawyer now, my father is a teacher. He just cooperated the use for seven of us and we all graduate. We all doing fine.
Amen.
It just cooperative. If it's not your turn, they will not give you. And you as a student, you have to work it out. We don't steal, we don't do anything. We don't do anything evil. But we work it out. You will see me. Am I fashionable? You will know, am I fashionable? When the morning comes plenty, I see what kind of suit I see, right? Look at it up, my pastor. It's only my bow leg you will see there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
From death to life.
Amen.
From death to life.
Amen.
So everything dying in your womb, every organ that is dead in your career, everything that is dying in your academics, it is from death to life. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From death to life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Revelation 1:18. I am he that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore.
Amen.
I am alive forevermore. Amen. And he has the keys of death and of sin. If he has the keys. In other words, sir, you and I are not meant to die more than 120 years.
Amen.
120 years, sir.
Amen.
That is what we are. David died at 17. He said to himself that he wants to go. It's a choice. If you want to go, but this assembly, nobody will go more than 120. The least you can go is 100.
Amen.
Don't rush yourself. The riches is on earth first. Yeah, enjoy it here. Yeah. Don't, no, don't say, no, the thing of the heart will go with the heart. The thing of the heart, enjoy it first before you go to the heaven. Man. If you don't serve him well, you don't enjoy well, you don't go there, you're going to be a servant when you get to heaven. Enjoy yourself well in God, not in a dubious way. People are riding beautiful cars, building beautiful houses. They are not Yahoo boys, they are not stealing. There is legitimate business, it's their money. Don't see anyone and say, no, is that your guy? In Yahoo boy. If some are not, even if it's Yahoo, don't you just like it in your own spirit's mind? Be rich in your own spirit's mind. From defeat to victory. Amen. No more defeat for you.
Amen.
That last interview that we have done is the last in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No more defeat for you. You are going for any kind of interview this week. I pray with you. And I call the God available. You will not see defeat in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's going to be victory for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are coming back with testimony in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From slavery to dominion. And what a privilege our dominion here. From slavery to dominion. Ephesians 2:6. Ephesians 1:20-21. Which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in heavenly places, far above principalities of power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also that which is to come. So you are meant to have dominion. If you read Ephesians 1:26, dominion. Dominion. We are meant to have dominion. Not to be a beggar, but to dominate. To dominate. To dominate. Colossians 2:14. Please get this Bible verse. Colossians 2:47. Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against you, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to cross. He has carried all these things. Please don't think them again. He has carried them. Even when he cannot carry it again, someone help him. All these things have been carried. He nailed them to cross. Your poverty has been nailed to cross.
Amen.
Your lack and want, your stagnation, your joblessness have been nailed to cross.
Amen.
Where do you get them? It has been nailed to cross. He carried all this and took it to cross and said, it is finished.
Amen.
That marital delay is finished.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That delay in the fruit of the womb is finished.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I said, Resurrection Day is Restoration Day. Resurrection Day is Restoration Day. And God said, I will restore those years, the camel, the palmawon, the caterpillar, it, I will restore.
Amen.
So it's a day of restoration. Watch it. It's restoring this assembly. It's restoring
Amen.
Us.
Amen.
Gradually.
Amen.
Gradually.
Amen.
Gradually.
Amen.
Gradually.
Amen.
Gradually.
Amen.
That will overflow.
Amen.
I've seen the way it was before. And it's today is the Resurrection Day. So it's restoring us. It's bringing them back. It's bringing them back. It's bringing new commands.
Amen.
It's bringing healing to this house.
Amen.
Where does one sign and wonders will launch us everywhere and anywhere?
Amen.
Just one healing. Just one. Just one. I caught the revelation and I told Brother Rebecca and sister, I said, if, Mr. Grace, if just one miracle happened from a notable man to a notable person in this America that just come, if one thing, maybe he or she is one or two sickness, and by privilege, God declared he or his or her healing, and from a notable family, he will just tell you, where do you want land from? He's a sudden God, he's a God of change.
Yes.
He's a sovereign God. He does things in his own time. When is his time? And this is his time. This is the time. You I'm telling you guys are too small. Where do you want the land? We have them here now. We have kind of Bill Gates and family and other big guys here. They will come. Amen. Watch it. Amen. Watch it. Amen. We are not despising our little beginning here. Mm-hmm. When God starts noising us abroad, they will say we don't even know what we now shall that people are using.
Amen.
But we are using God.
Yes. Amen.
And we are praying.
Amen.
God said it does not take fire, it takes fire. The kingdom of God suffered violence. And the violence taketh it by force. Please maximize this last week of kingdom prayer. Maximize it. Pray kingdom prayer. Lord bless your church. Heal the sick. Make the barren become a joyful mother of children. Let there be miracle jobs everywhere. No one go to any interview and fail anymore. He has named them to cross. He has what? Named them to cross. He has named them to cross. He has named all your sicknesses, all your poverty, all your joblessness, all kind of debt, all kind of slavery, all kind of poverty, all kind of it, captivity. He has named them to cross.
Amen.
He has named them to cross.
Amen.
He has nailed them to cross.
Amen.
He has named them to cross.
Amen.
Every kind of shame
Amen.
Has been nailed to the cross.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every kind of shame
Amen.
He has been nailed to the cross.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By Friday when he died, they were like crying. When he died, they were crying. Saturday. But the third day, joy came. Everywhere you have been crying, secret tears. Every kind of secret tears in your health, in your career. Every kind of secret tears that people are not seeing you, but you come to church and smile. And in your house you cry. Today is your day of rejoicing. Today is your day of rejoicing. Today is your day of rejoicing. They were crying, sir, on Friday. When the belly was on the cross. They were all mocking him. They were all laughing at him. They were all humiliating him. All kind of insult. On Saturday, the same thing. On Sunday, the third day, he rose up. I don't know where you have been down. But my God is raising you up this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. In your finances, you might have been down. In your situation, in your family, in the life of your children, you might have been down. But my God is raising you up today in the name of Jesus Christ. Men have mocked you in the first day. They mock you in the second day. This third day, they will celebrate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Please understand it. They laughed at him in the first day. They mocked him. They mocked him. He said, his spirit, everything was finished. They were humiliating him, all kind of. Let him rise then. They thought it was even stolen. They thought it was stolen. Every kind of grave that you have today, my God is taking you out in the precious name of Jesus Christ. But all these are for the sons and daughters of God. If there is any other day you have not given your life to Christ, today is supposed to be the best day to give your life to Christ. If there is any other day you have not given your genuine salvation is needed. Not just because you are a minister, you are a singer. If you are not genuinely born again, all we are seeing, and it's an anointing service. Before the anointing, if you are here this morning, you still smoke, you still drink, you still go clubbing, you still humanize, you still do adultery, you still tell lies. Please. Allow the resurrection power to resurrect you today. Allow the resurrection power to resurrect you today. Maybe you are once born again, but you missed it. This day is supposed to be the best day for you to give your life to Christ. This is supposed to be the best day to give your life to Christ. There is no better day to be saved like today. Please, if you are in the house, come outside. Privilege me to lead you to Christ again. Maybe you are once born again, but you missed it. This is the hour. The hour is now. If you don't do it now, when are you going to do it? Now that he has died and he has risen up, why not come with him to raise yourself up again? If you are in the house, you see smoke, you see the all kind of. Father, we thank you. We'll give you praise and glory. I know they are in the house. God says five people are in the house. Don't look for anybody. Don't wait for friends. It's a personal thing. Five good people are in the house. Five good people are in the house. Five good people. Four more. Forget your title. Forget it. It's not about you are one of the ministers, you are a choir, you are one of them. Forget it. Five good people are in the house. I know what God said. Five good people are in the house. Five. Genuine repentance. Five good people. Five good people are in the house. Don't fake it. Nobody fake it and make it a lie. Don't fake it. Five good people are in the house. You still do all kinds of stuff. You still smoke. You still tell lies. You still do all kinds. Let people don't know who is sitting beside you. Five good people. And three more. Genuinely. Let God touch you today. Let today be that day of salvation for you. Let it be a day, Holy Spirit, let the seed be hot for the remaining two people. Let the seed be hot for the remaining two people. Don't fake it. This is the best time to be saved. There is no any other place. This is the best time to be saved. This is the best time. Father, we thank you. Choir saying, I got my mind made up.
I got my mind made up and I won't turn back. 'Cause I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up and I won't turn back. 'Cause I want to see my Jesus someday.
Let's pray this prayer.